Hey, what's up? Hey, what's up? Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Just jumping on here to say what's up. Good morning to whoever pops on. See how everybody's doing. Just finished up my Sunday morning live on Instagram there, and figured I would jump on over here to TikTok. Good morning, and see how. No, not Starbucks. No. It's Eco Coffee. I don't drink Starbucks. This is Eco Coffee. It's a coffee house up in East Hampton, Connecticut, by my house. And this is I'm a vegetarian, so this is an oat milk mocha latte. Yeah, it's my one weakness. It's that one thing that I kind of. She's only open Thursday to Sunday, so Thursday to Sunday, that's my weakness. But anyway, as I was just saying, I just finished up my Sunday morning live on Instagram. I go live on Instagram every Sunday at 11 a.m. and I wanted to jump on right now and just see how everybody's doing, see what's going on with everybody. Some of you I have been I've sent messages to replied to your messages, and so you should definitely check your inbox here on TikTok to see if you have a message for me. But I have definitely been messaging some of you. Yeah, I see you there. You should definitely check your inbox, please. But other than that, what's going on, man? What's going on? Good morning. It was a really good live on Instagram this morning. We were talking about the three main points that I've been talking about and teaching online for the past almost 12 years now. A little longer, including Drumeo, because I worked with Drumeo. I'm good, brother. Thank you so much. Letitia, I'm good. Thank you so much. I'm really feeling good. Everything is fantastic. And as I was just saying, I worked with Drumeo for over 5 years, and I've been doing this online for about 12 years now, connecting with people. And the key points I've been trying to make with people throughout that time is, accept the fact that we all exist in a society that somebody else created long ago, and it's a society we had no say in creating. So it's always going to resonate a little negatively to us because this isn't the way we would want the world to be. That's why we always feel like, what the hell's going on in the world? We're controlled, we live in this society, somebody else created it, it's a monetary-based society, and we know that we was meant for so much more. The other thing I always try and teach people is that within, going deep inside yourself, beyond the noise and information and the teachings of man and the way of your parents and living under the expectations and the will and perspective of every single other person around you, constantly bending, being who they want you to be, that deep inside you, beyond the hurt, beyond the pain, beyond the joy, beyond the happiness, is where you're going to find your true deep stillness deep inside there. And that's who we truly are. And everything that we perceive to be in this world is only an action or an event that has happened before us, or a label that's been given to us. And that's the third part. So we exist in a world somebody else created long ago, a world we had no say in creating. The truth, the breakthrough you're looking through is deep within you. You have to go so far past the trauma, you've got to rip out of this shell and this perspective. And what happens to most people is they want to heal. Most people want to heal. They want to move forward. They want to open up. They want to let go of the pain. But they try to do it within the damaged perspective. They're holding on to this damaged mind, believing that they can function this way or things should happen this way, not realizing that perspective in of itself is what is holding them back. So the other thing we have to do is go so far deep within, beyond the noise, beyond the teachings, beyond the confusion, beyond the hate, beyond the joy, beyond the pain and happiness, back to that stillness and silence. And then when you're exactly. This is all about accessing the higher self. And then when you have become aware of this is not our created world, you've gone so far within that you now can exist as the observer beyond the thoughts and the emotions, you can separate them. Then what you learn to do is exist without labels. Think about this. I'm in my little cottage in my backyard right now. I've got my bowl, I've got my coffee cup, I've got my teapot, there's a towel, a blanket. When we look at these things, my coffee cup, my coffee is warm in there, it's chocolate, my bowl, I got a packet. You know, we start to look at these things and we start to create words and we start to identify with them more. We have to have, everything's got to have a meaning. We can't just observe. You see the trees outside, you see the crystals on the windowsill, you see the coffee cup. Don't use those words. No coffee cup, no window, no trees. Just see it. Force yourself to see it and feel and sense it without creating a label, without creating a story behind it, and start to try to do this with your life. As you are walking around now as this free being of being attached to that emotional state of existence by the fluctuating thoughts created by this insane society around us, where we are born and raised to bend to the will and perspective of everybody around us. Think about that. We come into the world, it's mom and dad, it's teachers, it's your boss, it's your girlfriend, your boyfriend, all the way up to God, your preacher, your church, the government, the cops. It's always somebody else that you've got to be somebody else to. And the sad thing is everyone in your life, everyone in your life, you can have two best friends who have known you since childhood. They each see you as somebody else. And we energetically try to meet and match this, and you're just fluctuating. And then what happens is we're so damaged, so lost, and so broken, we get into these relationships where we get manipulated and deceived by that negative energy because we're resonating in that negative energy. So you want to free yourself. You know, I sometimes say to people when I work with them privately that as beautiful as this is going to be, as peaceful as this is going to be, as amazing as you are going to feel when you come out of this, I am like a celestial sledgehammer, and we are going to really shatter that shell around you. And sometimes you can take somebody gently through the process, but sometimes some people are so trapped in that damaged perspective, they can't see any other way out but through it, that you've got to literally take them and metaphorically throw them into the fire. So you have to understand that your awakening, you know, it's not just, oh, there's something wrong with the world. I understand it. That whole process of awakening and evolution and ascension, enlightenment, it goes on and on and on and on and on and on and on. And it goes on so far beyond human comprehension, behind the human body. And with that, I'm gonna let you guys go. So here's the deal. Here's the deal. Listen, as I just said, I go live on Instagram on Sunday mornings at 11. I was trying to do it on both at the same time, but the other phone, the E's not working, so I can't access it. Can't type in my password. But every single Monday night, sometimes I put an event up on my page, but I don't. But every Monday night at 8 o'clock, and every Thursday night at 8 o'clock. Eastern Daylight Time, New York time, 8 o'clock East Coast, United States time. So if you're in England and you don't know what time 8 o'clock Monday night is, look up what time is it at 8 o'clock in New York, your time, and you'll figure it out. 8 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, I go live on TikTok, and I go live on TikTok on Thursday nights, and we do this. And I'm not just talking, I'm sitting here reading your questions and personally, directly connecting with you. So if you want to share tomorrow night, if you want to come in tomorrow night, if you want to hang out tomorrow night, 8 o'clock, I will be here. And honestly, you know, if you've got friends, if you've got family members that you know are going through stuff and they're looking for answers and stuff, then send them over here. I can send them the link. I can direct them to my first book, which has 55 questions in it. Channeled and answered. I have had a completely diverse life from, you know, climbing mountains through the jungle to being abused every way you can possibly imagine by my mother, sister, and family and stuff. I've had a very diverse life, and I've let every good moment and every bad moment become exactly what they are, lessons. Lessons that enable me how to move forward, and most importantly, lessons that enable me to reach a hand out and help somebody out or help somebody up when they are down or they are out. So again, if you want to come in tomorrow night or Thursday night, 8 o'clock, I'm always here on TikTok, and thank you very much. And I'm live on Instagram at 11 a.m. until I can get that going back up here. I guess it's time to get another phone. But anyway, Connie, thank you so much for the follow. EOS 777, thank you so much. and Kelly G. I couldn't get the rest of that. All right, Lauren. Well, and you guys can always private message me. I do get to them eventually, I promise. It does take a while, though. I'm a one-man show. And everybody, thank you so much. Massive love. Have a beautiful day. Make it so. Make it so. Remember, you know what you love. You know what you enjoy. You know what makes you happy inside. Surround yourself with that like there's nothing else in the world. And today will be a great day for you. I'll talk to you later, everybody. I'll see you tomorrow night, hopefully, 8 o'clock. Bye-bye.